Look at that leg.
I gotta like go on dance real quick. Oh my god, we gotta
leave market.
We're gonna be
and I'm all the road. Alright, what's tip?
So that should be 4, 5,
yeah,
they
could just see nothing.
Oh, stop. Perfect. You see that one? Oh, boom. They nailed it. In the back, you know what they needed to do. 3, stop. They're fixing to stop. Watch how perfect it is.
Oh,
right.
They all look the same.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. No, hold on.
What?
A run. I don't know what way down there. It's about
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On 28 October 1915, the Department of the Navy officially transferred Marine Corps recruit training to Parris Island. Among the first 750 Marines sent to Parris Island were the depot's first bandmaster, drum major, and a group of musicians from which the Paris Island Marine Band was formed. The musicians also doubled as marksmanship instructors, close combat instructors, and provided support for various units aboard the depot. A field music school was also established to train Marine musicians prior to their assignment to individual bands throughout the fleet. Today, the Paris Island Marine Band is one of the premier military bands in America. It consists of 50 members under the direction of the band officer, Chief Warrant Officer 2, Genovese, the band master, Master Sergeant Mike, the enlisted conductors, Gunnery Sergeant Shaw and Gunnery Sergeant Hendrickson, the instrument repair technician, Gunnery Sergeant Kocheski, the small ensemble leader, Staff Sergeant Hall, and the drum major, Staff Sergeant Gonzalez. The band travels throughout the United States, providing music for military ceremonies, community relations events, recruiting programs, and other official events. They also have the ability to perform as several specialty ensembles, such as ceremonial band, concert band, jazz ensemble, show band, and brass quintet, to name a few. While required to maintain a high degree of musical performance skills, these band members are above all else Marines and must remain capable of assuming the task common to all Marines, those of a basic Marine rifleman. The band's heritage dates back to the whistling fifes and rolling drums of the first Marines music back in 1775, and upholds the tradition of excellence and service to Corps and country, which is a proud legacy to all Marines. Ladies and gentlemen, the Paris Island Marine Band. The music this morning is presented by the Paris Island Marine Band. The drum major is Sergeant Taranzo, and the enlisted conductor is Sergeant Fox. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the graduation ceremony of Company K and Company N. The graduation ceremony that you are about to see is the culmination of the recruit training process and mark. The term devil dog is used today as a friendly reference between Marines, but the nickname has a proud history. It was first given to the Marines by German troops who fought against them at the Battle of Belleau Wood during World War I. In 1921, Major General Smedley Butler introduced the first bulldog as a Marine mascot. Now entering the parade deck is Paris Island's own devil dog, Lance Corporal Ophame. Lance Corporal Ophame is an English bulldog who enlisted in the Marine Corps on August 21st, 2017. She reported for recruit training on August 27th and graduated November 17th. Lance Corporal Ophame's handler is Lance Corporal Lilly of the Headquarters and Service Battalion. The staff for today's parade is comprised of drill instructors from the 3rd and 4th Recruit Training Battalions. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise. The chaplain of the 3rd Recruit Training Battalion, Lieutenant Footer, United States Navy, will deliver the invocation.
Ladies and gentlemen, spiritual development plays an important part in the making of a United States Marine. With that in mind, this prayer was written for the Marines of Kilo and November Companies. Let us pray. O God, as we gather together today, we give you thanks for giving us the courage, strength, and patience necessary to accomplish the goal of becoming United States Marines. Working through our diversity of culture and personalities, you have forged us into a team. And we thank you for seeing us through the physical, emotional, and the spiritual trials of training. You have surrounded us with loving family and friends who have supported us while we were here. And we thank you for seeing them safely to share in this special moment with us. We ask that you continue to watch over them and us, our Corps and our country, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Please be seated. Present day parades in the Marine Corps have their basis in both history and tradition. The massed formation of troops on one long line at close interval made possible the massing of firepower from muzzle-loaded muskets of yesterday. In those early days, the line of battle was just that, a line of two or three ranks, and looked much like the parade formation that you are about to see today. The adjutant forms the line for battle. The Marine marching across the parade deck is Gunnery Sergeant Granter. He is the parade adjutant and will very shortly give the command to begin the ceremony. His position, when he halts, indicates where the right flank of the formation will rest. Once positioned, he will draw his sword and supervise the placement of the formation.
Sound! Attention!
Marines have served aboard Paris Island since 1891, and more than 1 million Marines have been trained here. They have departed Paris Island for combat in conflicts throughout the world. The misty wheat fields of Bella Wood, the gritty beaches of the Pacific, the snow-capped mountains of Korea, the sweltering jungles of Vietnam, the parched desert sands of Kuwait, Iraq, and Afghanistan, and every other clime and place where Marines have sacrificed for country and Corps. The first called upon, the first to arrive, and the first to fight, the Marine Corps, the nation's force in readiness, has answered the call to numerous hotspots around the globe, showing the world once again that the United States Marine Corps is America's premier 911 force. Marching onto the parade ground is Company K and Company N. They began their training on June 16, 2018, and today's graduation marks the end of a demanding and difficult 12 weeks of training. These young men and women you see marching before you have met and mastered the challenge of recruit training. They have qualified with the service rifle and received basic warrior training. They have completed over 200 hours of academic instruction and participated in a rigorous physical training program that has developed their strength and stamina for the challenges ahead. Core values have been instilled in each of them, the meaning of honor, courage, and commitment. Marching before you this morning are 665 success stories, each of them a testament to the physical courage, dogged determination, and unyielding commitment to excellence that define the title Marine. This is what they have striven and persevered for, the right to walk across this parade deck as Marines. They have earned this title through demonstrated courage and achievement, and now join the proud ranks of over 1 million Marines who have graduated from Paris Island. From this day on, they will carry on the proud legacy and history of the United States Marine Corps. Ladies and gentlemen, the Marines of Company K and Company N. The platoons are being aligned from left to right in order to get them into their exact position for the ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and remove all hats for the playing of our national anthem. Thank you. Thank you. Please be seated. The parade adjutant now presents the command to the commander of troops, indicating that the parade is formed. At the command, Officer Center March, all unit commanders and guidon bearers march to the front and center of the formation. Historically, it was at this point that the commanding officer would issue orders and instructions to the unit commanders. Following this, the unit commanders would face about, return to their units, and pass the information on to their Marines.
Join a long line of patriotic men and women who have earned the title United States Marine. But they have not gotten here alone. The development of their character, values, and patriotism st- started with you. You created the foundation that placed them on this long and difficult, but very rewarding road to today. It was through the support of parents, family, and friends that they were able to complete recruit training. And your support will be necessary as they continue their enlistments in the Marine Corps. So on behalf of a grateful Marine Corps, I'd like to thank you for the role that you've played in the development of these Marines. Now I'd like to recognize a couple groups of Marines that are directly related to our success down here at Parris Island. The first are our recruiters. Our recruiters work long hours in hometowns just like yours, searching out the best and most fully qualified applicants. It was the recruiter that first convinced your Marine to even accept the challenge of becoming a United States Marine. So I'd like to thank them today and recognize them for their sacrifice and efforts. Finally, to our drill instructors. This group of highly professional Marines dedicates themselves to transforming recruits into Marines. Every day they set the example while instilling our core values of honor, courage, and commitment. The impact that the drill instructors have had on these Marines will be etched into their memories for the rest of their lives. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a round of applause for our drill instructors and their families. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'd like to address our new Marines. Good morning, Marines. Congratulations on completing recruit training and earning the title United States Marine. Please know that today is about you and what you've accomplished. However, after today, it's no longer about you. It's about all the people in the stands and the nation in which we serve. It's about the Marines standing to your left and to your right. It's about Marines that you haven't even met yet. And finally, it's about our core values of honor, courage, and commitment. If you remember these words, you'll do well. So from all of us here at Parris Island, congratulations on your accomplishment, and I wish you farewell in following seas. Semper Fidelis, Marines. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Corps' newest Marines.
Graduation ceremony is Mr. Gary Casaba. Mr. Casaba was born in Plattsburgh, New York, and graduated from Belmont Abbey College with a Bachelor's of Arts in Accounting. Upon graduation, he immediately went to work as an auditor with the Naval Audit Service, rising to the level of senior auditor in 3 years. In 1984, he was selected as a supervisory management engineer, conducting efficiency studies and developing organizational structures for Camp Lejeune. In 1987, he was promoted to the Deputy Assistant Chief of Staff for what is now known as Marine Corps Community Services at Camp Lejeune. In that capacity, he served as the Chief Operating Officer, overseeing the day-to-day operations with over 2,000 employees and generating over $150 million a year in revenue from retail and services sales. In 2006, Mr. Casaba retired from Camp Lejeune as a GS-15. He then moved to Beaufort, South Carolina, where he currently serves as the Director and CEO of Marine Corps Community Services. Now taking his position in the reviewing area is Mr. Casaba. He is being escorted by Sergeant Major Thomas, Sergeant Major, Recruit Training Regiment, Marine Corps Recruit Depot, Parris Island, South Carolina. During the pass and review, we ask that as the national colors pass before you, please rise. After they have passed, please be seated. The Commander of Troops, 1st Sergeant Palmer. His company commander is Captain Bates. The Parris Island Marine Band. Under the direction of the drum major, Sergeant Toronto, and the enlisted conductor, Sergeant Bach. Gunnery Sergeant Boyer, and the graduating Marines of the 3064 series. His series commander is Captain Johnson. The senior drill instructor of platoon 3064 is Sergeant Ramirez. He is assisted by drill instructor Sergeant Vick, Sergeant Harris Keough, and Sergeant Reynolds. The honor platoon for Company K is platoon 3065. The senior drill instructor is Staff Sergeant Long. He is assisted by drill instructors Staff Sergeant Buchanan, Sergeant Medina, and Sergeant Darden. The senior drill instructor of platoon 3066 is Gunnery Sergeant Shedd. He is assisted by drill instructors Staff Sergeant Gertie, Sergeant Benson, Sergeant Feeney, and Sergeant Unger. The senior drill instructor of platoon 3068 is Staff Sergeant Redmond. He is assisted by drill instructors Staff Sergeant Pete, Staff Sergeant Clark, and Sergeant Dye. The regimental color guard. The color sergeant is Sergeant Aguilar. Staff Sergeant Aranda and the graduating Marine of the 3068 series. His series commander is Captain Elzey. The senior drill instructor of platoon 3069 is Sergeant King. He is assisted by and Sergeant Deerfield. The senior drill instructor of platoon 3070 is Staff Sergeant Meade. He is assisted by drill instructor Staff Sergeant Parker, Staff Sergeant E, Staff Sergeant Toledo, and Sergeant Johnson. And the graduating Marine of the 4034 series. Her series commander is Captain Strum. The honor platoon for Company N is platoon 4034. The senior drill instructor is Staff Sergeant Medina. She is assisted by drill instructors Staff Sergeant Nanez, Staff Sergeant Kelsey, and Sergeant Robancho. The senior drill instructor of platoon 4035 is Staff Sergeant Solis. She is assisted by drill instructors Staff Sergeant Hunter, Sergeant Perez, Sergeant Haddock, and Sergeant Rakes. Thank you. company commanders of Company K and Company N, Captain Dennis and Captain Bate. The new Marines carrying the platoon guidons have been selected as the honor graduates for their platoons. They will now retire their guidons. The platoon guidons that are about to be retired have been the identification flags of each platoon throughout recruit training. To each, the guidon is a symbol of spirit, dedication, teamwork, and unit identity. The commanding officer of the 4th Recruit Training Battalion, Lieutenant Colonel Posey, will present the High PFT and Honor Graduate Awards. She is accompanied by the 3rd Recruit Training Battalion Sergeant Major, Sergeant Major Levy. We would like to thank the Marine Corps Association for providing the awards today. Please hold your applause until all of the awards have been presented. The most physically fit Marine of Company N is PFC Puente of Platoon 4035. PFC Puente scored 598 points out of 600 possible points. The company honor graduate for Company K is PFC Cobb of Platoon 3064. PFC Cobb is from Augusta, Georgia, and was recruited by Staff Sergeant Middlebrooks. The honor graduate for Platoon 3065 is PFC Franco. PFC Franco is from Kissimmee, Florida, and was recruited by Staff Sergeant Berrios. The honor graduate for Platoon 3066 is PFC Guerra. PFC Guerra is from Homestead, Florida, and was recruited by Staff Sergeant Davis. The honor graduate for Platoon 3068 is PFC Lassion. PFC Lassion is from Winfield, Louisiana, and was recruited by Sergeant Pope. The honor graduate for Platoon 3069 is PFC Lecompte. PFC Lecompte is from Wilmington, Delaware, and was recruited by Sergeant Brown. The honor graduate for Platoon 3070 and the most physically fit Marine of Company K with a score of 600 points out of 600 possible points is PFC Agrillo. PFC Agrillo is from Grand Rapids, Michigan, and was recruited by Staff Sergeant Wilson Ross. The honor graduate for Platoon 4034 and high shooter of Company N with a score of 338 out of 350 possible points is PFC Contreras. PFC Contreras is from Amarillo, Texas, and was recruited by Staff Sergeant Niederer. The company honor graduate for Company N is PFC Griffin of Platoon 4035. PFC Griffin is from Mount Pleasant, Michigan, and was recruited by Sergeant Bo. Marching onto the parade ground is the combat marksmanship instructor of Platoon 3064. The high shooter of Company K with a score of 338 out of 350 possible points is PFC Crane. Presenting the award today is the combat marksmanship instructor who is responsible for instilling the knowledge and the proficiency of the company high shooter. He is Sergeant Pacheco. Ladies and gentlemen, the distinguished graduates of Company K and Company N. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the playing of Anchors Away, which represents the historic partnership and shared legacy of the United States Navy and the Marine Corps, followed by the Marines hymn and the final dismissal. Gentlemen, the First Sergeants of Company K and Company N, Gunnery Sergeant Granter and First Sergeant Palmer. The senior drill instructors will now dismiss their platoons. This is the last and probably the most welcome order the new Marines receive from their senior drill instructor.